Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how you can use YouTube to share videos with friends and family by setting them to either private or unlisted. So I get asked all the time about how to share videos with just a select few people. For instance, people may want to email a video, which isn't very practical because video files are large and a lot of times people can't receive large files and they're difficult to send as well. I get asked maybe about burning to DVDs, but new Macs don't come with DVD burners, and DVDs are kind of becoming obsolete technology anyway, being standard definition, so that's not a good way either. A really good way is just to share them online, and the most popular video site, of course, is YouTube. So you can share your videos on YouTube. A lot of people don't want to do this because they don't want to publicly display their videos. They're not putting it up there to get attention. They just want to show a family member. So it's important to understand that when you share something on YouTube, you don't have to make it public. You can make a private video and you can make an unlisted video. And these are excellent ways to share videos with friends and family. So, for instance, here I'm in iMovie and I've just created a video here. It's an iMovie video. I've got transitions. I've got a title and everything. And I want to share this on YouTube. And there's two different ways to share on YouTube. One is to use the share button here. And I can select YouTube. And if I wasn't logged into my test YouTube account here, it would say log in right here and I'd click on it and log in. If you don't have a YouTube account, you can get one. It's a Google account. So if you use Gmail, if you use Google Plus, if you use any Google service like Google Play or anything, you have a Google account, which means you have a YouTube account. If you don't, of course, you just sign up for one. Google's everywhere, so most people have some sort of Google account now. So you sign into that, and now you can share directly from iMovie. So here's the video. I haven't even exported or done anything. I've just edited it here, and it's ready to go. I can title it. I can add a description, and all this is going to be included with the upload. So I'll just leave it like that. I can add tags if I want. For sharing something privately, none of this is really that important, but you do want to make sure you name it something reasonable so the person knows that they're viewing the right thing. And you can select the size. There's really no reason, unless you have very low bandwidth, to go lower than what the maximum is, which will be set. And category probably doesn't really matter if you're just sharing privately. Now here's where you set private, unlisted, or public. It'll probably default to public. Private and unlisted are the two options you want to choose. I'll discuss what's different about each one soon. Let's choose private for now. And I'll hit next. And then this will give me a little terms of service thing. I'll hit publish. And that's it. I'll get a notification when it's uploaded. Otherwise, it just does it in the background. I can continue doing what I'm doing. And it usually takes just a few minutes for a short video like this. Maybe a little longer for a longer video. Now that's the first way to upload a YouTube video. I never use that method. Instead, I use the basic method of just going to YouTube on the web and I click the upload button. Doing it through the web gives you access to every feature and every option YouTube has. It's their primary way that people get things up into YouTube. And it's very easy to use from iMovie. You can't just do it right from the share button here, but instead I simply share and just export it as a file. And then select what I want. And this will also give me a nice file that I can have on my hard drive for other things. So I do all the same stuff here. Hit next and I will be done with the video. There's that the YouTube video I uploaded before. Got my notification it's shared. So I would just export it as a file. And once I've exported it as a file, then I can drag and drop that into here. Before or after I do it, I can set it to public, unlisted, or private. And then I get to set everything. So for instance, let's go and give that a try here. I will export this. And I'll just save it to my desktop. And then I'll be able to upload that to YouTube once it's done. So now that I see that it's done, I can see it here on the desktop and I can drag and drop it here. And now I can set everything. I can set the title, description, the tags. I could change it to private or unlisted. And notice here that I get, through this interface, the ability to add names, circles, or email addresses. So when you share something privately, you have to specify who gets permission to look at it. And they have to have an account with Google. Otherwise Google doesn't know who they are. So names and circles apply to if they have a Google Plus account, if they use Google Plus. Email address could be anything, like a Gmail address, for instance, would be perfect. People can have Google accounts that aren't Gmail addresses, but if it is a Gmail address, then automatically it is a Google account. So you find out their Google account email address, and you can add as many as you want in here, and then those people have permission, and nobody else can actually even get to the file. So it truly is private and secure. And they'll also get a notification that the video was shared with them. If instead I chose unlisted, then there are no options like that, because simply what happens is the video will be listed. It will be at a address, and here is actually the address where the video will be located when it's done uploading. And anybody can go and view that, but nobody knows it exists. It won't show up in search engines. It won't show up anywhere. It's almost like if you had your own little account, you know, in the days of AOL or MySpace or GeoCities or any of that stuff, and you just put a picture or a video up there and you just told people where it was. It's technically not secured behind any kind of wall where people can't get past, but nobody can find it unless you send them this link. That's the best option for 99% of the use when people ask me, how do I share videos? Because you just want to share something maybe just for a short period of time, a couple of weeks, and you want to put it up somewhere. You can send this link in an email or a Facebook post to friends. They can view it and you can take it down later on or not. And it's just very easy to do. They don't have to have a Google account. You don't need to know what their Google account is. And you can actually then share it with other people or tell them, hey, share it with the whole family, that kind of thing. And everybody can just view it there. So unlisted for 99% of the use, private if you really think you need for some reason to secure it, and that's how you can get your video up on YouTube. When I go and I look at the video manager now, I'm going to see there's the two videos because I uploaded one from iMovie and the other one I uploaded manually through the web interface, which is the way I like to do it. And now I can do other things, like I can get info and things like this, go back in and edit, get the, I can click on it to actually go to the YouTube page for it there, and I can share this link with anybody I want. The great thing about sharing to YouTube, and the reason I like to do this, is YouTube is available so many places. My television, which is 2 years old at this point, has a YouTube app in it, and I can view this video on my television. Apple TV, any other set-top box like Roku, a lot of cable boxes, a lot of satellite boxes have YouTube apps, and you can view it. Any iPad, any Android tablet, any computer at all can view this video. So you can send this out, and just about anybody with a device that connects to the internet can view YouTube videos and can now view this video. It's a lot different than trying to share it other ways, which may be more difficult for them to be able to view your video.